I'm afraid, very afraid, that AI is making us way, way dumber. And I know that's not some shocking discovery. I'm not the first one to state or think that. And I'm not just thinking that since today, instead, pretty much since the early days of ChatGPT and when this entire AI revolution started, I had my doubts and worries, as I'm sure most of us have. Now, that might be kind of a surprise to some people because I built an AI-powered business headshots site, which allows people to generate business headshots with AI. I'm not the first one, I know, but it's arguably easier, cheaper, and I guess better than most other services I've found out there. I got courses on AI topics. I have a lot of videos about AI, and not in all of them I'm skeptical. And just yesterday, I had a live stream where we built a video generation app with help of Sora too. So I'm doing a lot of AI stuff. And at the same time, I'm worried that we're getting dumber. Am I maybe just getting dumber? Well, possible, but mostly I feel that we got AI. It's there to stay, and it does unlock interesting new capabilities. It can make you more productive, especially also as a developer. I truly believe that, but at the same time, there are so many significant risks attached to AI and attached to using AI. And that's what I want to share some thoughts about, or that's what I want to talk about. Because obviously, as a developer, and that is kind of my perspective because I am a developer, AI is really that two-edged sword. On the one hand, we're afraid that it will take our jobs, that in some years, in like 5 years, I don't know, it may be able to generate pretty much all the code, self-improve, and at some point we gotta ask ourselves if we still need to write or even control check the code that has been written. So that's one thing. At the same time, today, AI can make you more productive if used right, but using it right is so difficult. It's so easy to fall into the trap of endless prompting and of trying to write all the code, generate all the code with AI. And whilst generating code with AI can be fun to some degree, debugging code with AI is absolutely no fun. And it's super easy to forget that you're able to write code yourself and, well, just keep on prompting and prompting and try to fix that bug with AI by throwing more prompts at it instead of just going into the code and fixing a certain problem on your own or implementing a certain feature on your own. And at some point, it gets actually pretty difficult to do something on your own because as the code base evolves and as almost no code in that code base was written by you, it gets harder and harder to understand that code base and to make changes in it. And I'm sure we've all been there. I've definitely been there. At the same time, of course, using AI to implement individual features, small features, make smaller changes, or refactor code in ways that could be pretty annoying because it might just be a bunch of stupid copy and pasting if you did it on your own. These are the parts where AI can shine, in my opinion. The same for smart AI-powered auto-completion, like the tab feature in Cursor. It can be annoying. It can often suggest the wrong stuff, and you accidentally accept it by hitting tab too quickly. But when it works, and it does work a decent amount of the time, for me at least, you can really fly through your code base and make changes quickly. But it's, as I mentioned, so hard to get that balance right and to not rely on AI too much. And that's where I see the big danger. As we rely too much on AI, we might not be more productive. We might be less productive because we spend so much time waiting for the AI to hopefully fix a certain problem or to get something right. We might end up with code bases that are super hard to manage and where we got no understanding of what's going on in those code bases. We might use it so much that we actually got dumber and we lose our skills. We lose our skill to build programs and to write code ourselves. And That is a real danger I see. Even as someone who has written a lot of code, I would call myself a very experienced developer, but even as such an experienced developer, I sometimes find myself lost in code bases or, really forgetting how to implement a certain feature or how to do something which I have done in the past, but maybe not in the last couple of months. And since I'm now using so much AI, I don't know all the things I used to know. And I'm really afraid of that. And that is a reason why I'm actively trying to reduce my amount of usage of AI as a developer during developing. I'm not cutting it down to zero. I'm still using AI, but I find it very important to control your usage, to take a step back from time to time, and to still write code on your own, because you really lose your skills otherwise. It's use it or lose it, right? It's the same for all skills in life, and it is definitely also the case for writing code. But I am not just worried about AI making me or us dumber when it comes to writing code. We got Sora 2 now. We got video generation models for a couple of months now, but Sora 2 is really good. We got a lot of other models for generating audio. Obviously, the large language models for generating text. We got those image generation models. And I don't know, you gotta be worried about what all these models and capabilities mean for the future of humanity, if you want to put it like this. Deep fakes are already possible to a certain extent. Yeah, there are some errors here and there, sure, but you can really generate images or videos that are hard to distinguish from reality. And again, I got my own website that allows you to generate images with AI, but images based on you to just put you into a different pose and give you a certain attire. But of course, you can generate all kinds of things with AI, not just put yourself into a suit. You can really generate videos now with Sora 2 that look like reality or almost like reality. And not everybody out there will see or understand that a certain video is AI. There are people that think that everything they see on TikTok or Instagram is real, and it's not. And to be very honest, even you and me, who got some understanding of what's going on in the AI space, even we will definitely often be tricked into thinking that something's real if it's not. And that can't be good for humanity. And our brains are rotting since years already with all the short form content. And yeah, now I'm just that old guy. Not that old, I guess, but I grew up without TikTok and Instagram, and I know I'm just that guy that complains about the future and how everything was better in the past, but I'm really worried about where this will all take us for humanity as a whole, as I said, because our attention spans get shorter and shorter and shorter. There are more fakes out there. There will be lots of people that use those capabilities for bad things, for scams, for fraud of all kinds. So that's something we have to be worried about. And yeah, I'm just not sure if that's all shiny and great. And don't get me wrong, as I said, there are great use cases. Being able to produce stock footage, if you're a video creator, with help of tools like Sora is great. Though, to be fair, there is the entire copyright thing going on. That stock footage, or that B-roll, not stock footage, the B-roll you're producing, is of course in the end based on a model that was trained on likely copyrighted material. So that is a whole different thing. But the use case you unlock, being able to generate B-roll that fits your video perfectly without you searching through stock footage libraries for hours, that's great. I won't lie about that. I see other valuable use cases too, though again, you can always also argue if it's really that valuable that some things get easier when they previously had to be done by humans, if those humans are then put out of their jobs. So again, you can have an ethical and philosophical discussion about that, but you could also argue that these are good use cases. They make things simpler. We got all the bad use cases too, though. And again, the brain rot thing. If we consume more and more AI-generated slop, if the internet gets flooded by more and more AI content, I'm not sure if that's such a great future. So anyways, these are just my thoughts of that or about that. As always, let me know what you think, what your take on this is. Maybe I'm just getting grumpy and old, but yeah, let me know what you think.